Hello, I am Dirkje, and this is the Tribe of the Fox. In the Netherlands and in Belgium we say the Stam van de Vos. And today I want to talk about witchcraft. A witch used to be seen as a wise woman or a wise man. And the word witch in Dutch is hex. And that word comes from the Middle Dutch word Hagetesse. And this word means hedge driver. That's a nice word, isn't it? Hedge driver. Because as a hedge driver, you move on the border of the visible and the invisible world. In Scandinavia, the word vulva is used for the female variant. And now these days, there are of course different types of witches. And I do not have any judgment on what everybody is doing and how everybody feels in their life concerning occultism and witchcraft. We are not about dogmas and rules. Everybody feels in their own way of living. But first, of course, you have the Wicca. The Wicca is still, I think, modern. It's still a hype for younger girls, and it is interesting to set your first steps into the occultism and to be a witch. Yeah, and for me, and I'm speaking about my own experience, Wicca and witchcraft are not really the same, although they are often seen as the same. Wicca is developed during the 50s by Gerald Gardner. This was more or less a form of organized witchcraft. Wicca practitioners based their ideas on pre-Christian sources. Also, European folklore and mythology, of course. And this all from a modern point of view. I once started in the Wicca myself. And I was taught by very lovely and very authentic people. Yeah, it was nice because I was taught by a couple, older people, and they were experienced. They were not full of bullshit or dogmas, and that was very nice. And after that, I started to join a coven. And I found out that in that group, it was important how you looked. The rules were important. There was a hierarchy of high priests. And yeah, that all was more important than my own development. And just before that, I left the church and I got a feeling that I had ended up in a church again. But of course, this was my experience. Enough about Wicca. After that, I decided to be a solitary witch, not connected to any group or whatever. And I was doing my own research, finding my own way in the witchcraft. And what I did like about it was that no rules. Yeah, still interesting for me, no rules. And you know, if you are really a witch, then it's not about how you look. And when I started, I dressed like a witch and I wear gothic clothing. But now it's not important. I have still gothic clothing in my locker, but I hardly wear it. It's not important. It's not about how I look. And people, if they look to me, they don't see that I'm a witch. Sometimes they do, because they can feel it. But it's not because I'm dressed up in black and black lipstick and black nail polish or whatever. But sometimes they do. Sometimes they see that I'm a witch, but yeah, normal people, they don't see it. It's not important for me anymore. If you find your own way in witchcraft, it is a kind of path that you can walk on, a paved path that other people walked, but you can find your own path in that. And it's ancient. If you connect to your own ancient path, you connect to your ancestors, you connect to nature. And I used to do rituals a lot, and that was good, because practice is good. I did not do it on a regular basis, but yeah, sometimes I did do that a few days, and then a few weeks I did not do anything. And I went to sacred places in the Netherlands. There is a woman, her name is Judith Cruijff, I think. She wrote a book about sacred places in the Netherlands, old sacred places, and I started to visit those places. And yeah, and that is what is going about witchcraft for me. To be aware of your own surroundings, to be aware of your own country, to search for your root, to search for the spirits of your own land. Yeah, to do rituals if you like, to read stories about folklore. I like the fairy tales, and I have a few old books that tell stories about this area where I live in, and in the area of the north part of the Netherlands, because there are very, very old books available if you want to find them and to see what's in them. That's nice. I like to see and to find out how people lived. I speak. People sometimes think I'm crazy because I speak with trees and animals and plants. Yeah, because that is animism. As a witch, I believe that everything has a soul. And that a tree, yeah. Maybe you have seen the movie that Martijn did make about connecting with trees. And it is not about the new age thing or something. Oh, I can talk with trees and love and peace, but it is connecting with the soul of a tree. And that is really possible. That is really interesting. And I used to do also magic. And magic is not about manipulating the outer world. It's about your inner growth. It's about your own mindset. And of course you can play with synchronicity. And synchronicity is kind of connection between your inner world and the outer world. And I have had nice experiences with that. But it's not a tool to manipulate your will. Or more important, somebody else's will. It's about finding your will. It's about playing with your own mindset. And what I see is a lot of people think very negative about themselves, about their situation, about the past, about the future. And magic is actually think in a different way. Think in a positive way. And sometimes a ritual can help. Because when I do a ritual, the first step I take is going into my body. Not in my head or above my head or higher than that. No, into my body. Because when I'm completely in my head and I go to do a kind of meditation or something, then my experience is that I can make things up. I can fantasize very easily because I have a big imagination. But when I go into my body and make a deeper connection with my own body, then it's different. Then things seem to come from another source. And that's a very important message. If you walk on the path of occultism, witchcraft, paganism, or to be a heathen, first go into your body. Feel your body, feel your emotions, feel the energy around you, feel the energy in you. Connect with the earth. That is very, very important, because when you're in your head, you're going to float and you're available for everything, and every image comes up, and yeah, that brings a lot of unrest and unclear images. So going into your body, and that is also a path that can take years. I mean, I'm practicing going into my body, I think for, well, maybe 20 years. And still practicing going into my body, because when I have only thoughts and images in my mind, yeah, that's not working for me. It has to be a kind of quiet in my mind before I see things or get a kind of images or impressions. And that path is very interesting to walk. Maybe people judge you, and maybe people think you're out of your mind. To talk with trees and to feel near streams and to search for the spirits of the country. But it is a real world. It's another world, and it is really connected with what you see. It's not that far away. It's not that difficult to experience things. And the second thing is, it's also nice to read. To read what other people investigated, to learn, to see what other people's experiences are. But stay true for yourself. I mean, don't believe everything. Don't believe everything I tell you. Search for your own truth. And that is very important on the path of witchcraft, occultism, paganism. And it's also nice to be with other people. I mean, I did walk my path very solitary for a long time. And it's also nice to connect again. Because when you find your own path, then you connect with people that suit. You grew, and you attract other people who grew on the same way. And that's nice. That's always nice. And never, never do what other people tell you what you have to do. I mean, when I was in the Wicca, they told me that I had to carry a knife with a black lemmet and a white rope around my middle, yeah, purple candles or whatever. Yeah, fuck that. That's not about witchcraft. That's about rules. Find your own colors. Do what you want. If you want to dance naked in the middle of the forest, please do that. If you want to dress up like a witch, please do that. But go your own path. Do what you want. Do what you like. It's funny because I was also interested in Aleister Crowley and he's talking about the law of Thelema, and that is about doing what you want without harming others. And you can tell things about Aleister Crowley, but this is really, really a good thing. This is going deep, because doing what you want without harming others, that's the only law. That's really, really a philosophical way of thinking, and it gives a lot of freedom. So it's all about freedom. It's all about you and your path. And it doesn't matter if you are doing witchcraft, rituals with pagan friends, going alone in the forest, staying indoors. I advise you to go outdoors. But sometimes you stay indoors. It's up to you. It's completely up to you. I only want to inspire you to go and walk your own path. Okay, this is it for now. If you have questions or want to put something in the comments down below, I'll appreciate it. Thanks for watching, and I see you next time. Bye-bye.